Hallelujah, precious saints. Well, this very day, I'd like to pray prayers of binding and loosening. Hallelujah. Now, we just done a teaching recently on this, so you can watch that teaching also. But I just want to get into the prayer aspect and deliverance part of it so that it may help and benefit you today. Hallelujah. So the Bible says in Matthew 12:29, or how can one enter a strong man's house and plunder his goods unless he first binds the strong man, and then he will plunder his house. Hallelujah. So every born-again Christian has authority to bind evil and loosen God's plan into every situation. So you have that authority today to bind any evil that may be coming against your life. So all you need to do today is bind that thing and bring it into captivity under the obedience of Christ. So the Bible also tells us, according to the word of God, in the scripture, it says these words, and Jesus said, I tell you the truth, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loosen on earth will be loosened in heaven. Again, I tell you that if two of you on earth agree about anything you ask for, it shall be done for you by my Father in heaven. For where two or three comes together in my name, there I am with them in the midst, according to Matthew 18:18-20. So there is power in agreement today. So all I'm asking you to do is to be in agreement with God's word, with God's promise. And according to Psalm 149:5-9, it talks about that saints are being given the permission to bind up the kings and the rulers, the principalities and powers, the things that have been dominating, the strong men over your life, to bind them with fetters, to bind them with chains. And this authority has been given to all the saints of God, according to Psalm 149:9. The very last verse says that all the saints have been given this authority. What is that authority for? That authority is to bind up. And according to Matthew 16:19, it says, I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on this earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever you loosen on this earth shall be loosened in heaven. And we understand that those keys represent the actual action of faith of binding and loosening. So we don't have to wait for the keys of authority to come. They have already been given in the action of faith of binding and loosening. So whatever needs to be loosened shall be loosened. Whatever needs to be bound shall be bound. Hallelujah. Because we understand that the definition of binding is, so when you bind something for prohibiting it from happening and putting it into chains. So we are binding, we are prohibiting, we are forbidding that thing. And what does loosening mean? The define loosen is the opposite action. So untying something or loosening it, you are setting it free. So we are going to loosen what God wants to bring about in your life, and we're going to bind up things that are coming against you. So in likewise, in each of your lives, I bind up pride in the name of Jesus, and I loosen humility. That is what you would do when you identify certain aspects in your life that need to be bound up. Or if we're talking about fear, I bind up fear and I loosen the perfect love of Christ. Because according to 1 John 4:8, it says there is no fear in love, but perfect love drives out fear. Because fear has to do with punishment. And the one who fears is not made imperfect in love. So we understand that the word of God has power. So according to Jesus, according to Matthew 16:19, He said he has given us the keys of the kingdom. Whatever we bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Therefore, we bind up the enemy and every evil angel that was kicked out of heaven from interfering with our blessings coming into our lives. We bind every principality, every power, every might, every dominion, every ruler of darkness, and every spirit in high places from interfering within our lives, within our families, within our health, within our finances, within our ministry, within our business, within our relationships, within others, and more importantly, with you, Lord. Anything that is hindering our relationship with you, that they will not be able to operate in any aspect of our life or have any influence over it according to your perfect will and word within our lives. And Lord Jesus, we also therefore loosen on earth, Lord, that will be loosened in heaven. Therefore we ask, Lord, that you will give the angels of heaven charge over us according to Psalm 91. Lord, and we ask that you loosen the angels to hearken the word of God on our behalf. Loosen your blessings and favor over our life, over our family, over our health, over our finances, over our ministry, over our business, over our relationships, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We just thank you today, Father, because according to Matthew 6, verse 10, first, we bind the plans of the enemy in the name of Jesus Christ, and we call forth God's will to be done on earth as it is in heaven. Father, in heaven, we stand in faith on the authority that we have as believers in Jesus Christ and in co-heirs to your kingdom. In the name of Jesus Christ, we bind every evil spirit and every evil plan made in every situation within our life, and we cancel the enemy's plans and call forth God's plan within our situation right now. God's word says that God has plans for good and not an evil, according to Jeremiah 29 verse 11. And for us, we claim those plans now, Father. We ask that your will be done in this situation as it is done in heaven. And we give thanks and praise to you. Father God, we thank you for sending your son to die for us and rescuing us, Lord, and resurrecting him to sit at your right hand in heaven right now. And we thank you for bestowing upon him all power and authority over evil. In the name of Jesus Christ, we speak to every evil spirits. We bind you from attacking us now and throughout this day and from here henceforth. And we ask you to leave now and go straight back to the pit of hell right now in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray right now that every voice, that every tongue that is coming under this voice that is speaking, that it may come and hearken to this voice. We decree and we declare upon each person listening today as we go into a time of binding right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, we bind up all these spirits and all spirits that are related to each and every area right now in the name of Jesus. We bind every evil spirit in our life according to Acts 19 verse 15 in the name of Jesus. We bind all foul spirits within our lives according to 2 Corinthians 3 verse 17 in the name of Jesus. We bind all familiar spirits within our lives according to Deuteronomy 18 verse 10 to 11 in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind the spirit of fear within our lives according to 2 Timothy verses 4, chapter 4 verse 1 in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind the lying spirits within our lives according to 2 Chronicles 18 verse 22 in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We bind the spirit of any perverse spirit within our lives according according to Isaiah 19, verse 14, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We bind the spirit of rebellion within our lives, according to Psalm 78, verse 8, in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind the seducing spirits within our lives, according to 1 Timothy 4:1, in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind the spirit of divination within our lives, according to Acts 16, verse 16, in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind the spirit of error within our lives, according to 1 John 4:6, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I bind the spirit of infirmity within our lives, according to Luke 13, verses 11, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I bind the spirit of whoredom within our lives, according to Hosea 5, verse 4, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I bind the spirit or any unclean spirits within our lives, according to Mark 1, verse 23, verse 24, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I bind the spirit of jealousy within our lives, according to Hosea 5, verse 4, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus. I bind every spirit of frustration, defeat, delaying blessings, and fear in our environment in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I bind the spirit of death, armed robbery, assassination in our neighborhoods in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I bind and I render to nothing all the strong men that are currently troubling anybody's life right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind you, the strong man within our lives, and I clear all of our goods from your possessions in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind every strong man militarying against our home in the names of Jesus Christ. I bind the strong man over our lives in the name of Jesus. I bind the strong man over our family in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind the strong man over our blessings in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind the strong man over our business in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind and plunder the goods of every strong man attached to our marriage in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind and paralyze every strong man of death and hell in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind and cast out every power causing internal warfare in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind all evil remote control spirits in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind every spirit manipulating our beneficiaries against us in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind every spirit sitting on our possessions in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind the wills of every person known and unknown in the name of Jesus Christ that is coming against the will and the mind of Christ within our lives in the name of Jesus. I bind our body, soul, and spirit to the mind, emotions, person, and the purpose and the will of God for our lives right now in the name of Jesus. I bind our minds to the mind of Christ so that the very thoughts and feelings and purposes of our heart would be within our thoughts of Christ and Christ alone. I bind our feet to the paths of righteousness so that their steps would be steady and sure. I bind each of us to God's timing in our lives and His alone in the name of Jesus. I bind us to the work of the cross and to all its mercy, grace, love, and forgiveness and dying to self in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind and cast out satanic harassment and rebuke satanic concentrations and bring to a halt and prohibit all satanic surveillance right now in the name of Jesus. I bind and cast out every lying spirit, every gossip, slandering, backbiting, disloyalty, waywardness, wandering, and every negative spirit, and I bind in our hearts or minds and spirit to the mind of God and the Holy Spirit right now will bring freedom in the name of Jesus. I bind and paralyze the strong men employed and delegated to disgrace us right now in Jesus' name. I bind and put to flight all the spirits of fear and anxiety and discouragement right now in the name of Jesus. I bind and I render to nothing all the strong men that are currently troubling our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind you, strong man, within our lives, and we that are trying to clear our goods, and we clear them from your possessions as we return back seven times what is rightfully ours, according to Proverbs 6, verse 31, in the name of Jesus. We bind every strong man, Lord, militarying or anything against our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind and paralyze every strong man of death and hell in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind and render to naught all the strong men that are currently troubling our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. We come against and bind up the spirit of slavery in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind up every spirit of Herod in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind every astral spirit and command them to loosen their hold over our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind every spirit of strife in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind and glue these familiar spirits to one another that they may also be brought to confusion in the name of Jesus Christ. Relocate them to the land of the wicked, and we release the brimstone and sulfur of the Lord to burn them to ashes in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind and glue these astral spirits to one another and to their leader right now. We relocate them to the land of the wicked and release them to brimstone and sulfur of the Lord to burn them to ashes in Jesus' name. We bind and glue these marine spirits to one another and to their leader, and we relocate them to the land of the wicked and release brimstone and sulfur of the Lord to burn them to ashes now in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind and render to nothing all strong men that are currently troubling anybody's lives in the name of Jesus Christ. We say right now in the name of Jesus Christ, you will loosen your hold today from us in the name of Jesus. We bind off all and reinforcements right now in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind Satan first, then each and every one of them up and off from him and from those above, around and below, and all above, around and below, up and off from the ruler spirits, principalities and powers, and from each other. And we bind every evil presence in our bodily system, the reproductive, the digestive, the respiratory, the nervous, the skeletal, the muscular, the circuitry, the excretory, every aspect of us, we bind it right now. We bind up every evil power pulling anything in our bodies towards evil by means of energy drawn from the sun, the moon, and the stars in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind every power pulling anything in our bodies towards evil right now in the name of Jesus, drawn from the planets, the constellations, and the earth in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind up, tear down, and cast away the spirits of Jezebel, Ahab, divorce, and separation in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind and rebuke any serpent that would try to deceive us, according to 2 Corinthians 11:3. We bind up and rebuke every serpent that would try to twist or coil around in our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind and rebuke every python that would try to squeeze out our prayer life in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind and rebuke every cobra that would try to come against us in the name of Jesus. We bind up and rebuke every animal, every enemy that's coming against us now in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind and rebuke every flying serpent that would attack our lives in the name of Jesus, according to Isaiah 27 verse 1. We bind and rebuke every sea serpent that would try to attack our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind every Jezebel spirit, marine spirit, water spirit, spirits, queen of the coast spirit, familiar spirits, witches and witch wizards, and every spirit of dead occult spirits operating in our lives with hot chains, fetters of God, and cast you out into the deep and seal you with the unquenchable fire of God right now in the name of Jesus. We bind and rebuke the spirits of Jezebel that are operating against us right now in the name of Jesus Christ. every spirit of Jezebel, Ahab, Absalom, Canaan, Korah, or Ashtaroth, in the name of Jesus Christ, we bind you right now. Every strong man of sickness, every strong man of fear, every seducing spirit, we bind you now in the name of Jesus Christ. And we command you right now to come out of us right now and all go back to the pit of hell right now in the name of Jesus Christ. And right now, we loosen the spirits of God in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I loosen into each one listening to us and into their families, the angels of God to fight our battles in the heavenlies. Let them guard us from Satan and all his hosts who would have us believe and agreeing with lies. We bind all deception within us to prevent any more from getting through to us. Lord, minister to our needs. Father, we ask in the name of your precious Son that you would send ministering spirits to us in the name of Jesus Christ. Loosen us from every spirit right now as we declare them right now and into our lives, the freedom that comes through Christ Jesus in the name of Jesus. We loosen the spirit of wisdom upon us according to Exodus 28 verse 3 in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We loosen the spirit, oh Lord, to give us according to Matthew 5 3. It says the poor in spirit shall inherit the kingdom of God. Lord, we want that poor in spirit, that humble spirit. We ask for the spirit of God according to Genesis 1 verse 2. We ask, Lord, that you would loosen the spirit. Lord, according there is a spirit of our Father according to Matthew 10 verse 20. Lord, we thank you for the spirit of the Lord to be loosened according to Jude 3:10. We ask for the spirit, Lord, the strong spirit within us according to Luke 1 verse 30. Let it be loosened. Let it be loosened, the right type of spirit according to Psalm 51 verse 10. Lord, we want that right contrite heart spirit. Lord, we also thank you, Lord, for the spirit of truth to be loosened into our lives according to John 14 verse 17. We thank you for the Holy Spirit, Lord, to be loosened upon us according to Psalm 51 verses 11. We thank you, Lord, for the spirit of life according to Romans 8 verse 2 to be loosened upon our life today in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you for Psalm 51 verse 17 says a broken spirit and a contrite heart. We want that broken spirit. We want that humble spirit. We ask, Lord, for Romans 8 15, which talking about a spirit of adoption, that we might cry out, Abba Father. We have that today in salvation, and we receive it right now in the name of Jesus Christ. We also thank you for Psalm 76 verse 12. It talks about the princes. There's a spirit of princes. We are princes and heirs in Christ Jesus, and we thank you for that. We thank you for a fervent in spirit according to Romans 12 verse 11. We ask that you loosen that fervent in spirit upon us, that we may be fervent in heart in the name of Jesus Christ. We also thank you for, Lord, faithfulness. Lord, we want a spirit of faithfulness to be loosened upon us according to Proverbs 11 verse 13. We thank you, Lord Jesus, that you will loosen a spirit of meekness upon us according to 1 Corinthians 4 verse 21. We also thank you because according to Proverbs 16 verse 19, you will loosen a humble spirit upon us. Lord, we thank you according to 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 13, you will loosen a spirit of faith upon us that we may have faith to do greater works for you in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord Jesus, Lord, that you would loosen an excellent spirit upon us according to Proverbs 17 verse 27. Oh Lord, that you would loosen right now, Lord, that eternal spirit according to Hebrews 9 verse 14 upon us. We thank you that you will loosen the spirit of patience upon us according to Ecclesiastes 7 verse 8. Lord, that you would loosen the spirit of meekness and quiet spirit upon us according to 1 Peter Peter verses chapter 3 verse 4. We thank you, Lord Jesus, that you would loosen a spirit of good sleep upon us according to Isaiah 29 verse 10. We thank you, Lord, that we would be rulers and not slaves according to Ecclesiastes 10 verse 4. We thank you, Lord, for the spirit of glory according to 1 Peter 4 verse 14. We thank you, Lord, that you've given us authority to even judge, Lord, according to Isaiah 4 verse 4. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for a spirit of prophecy to come upon each person according to Revelation 19 verse 10, because Jesus is a spirit of prophecy. We thank you, Lord, for the spirit of understanding to come upon us according to Isaiah 11 verse 2, that it'll be loosened upon us. We thank you for the spirit of Elijah, Lord, according to 2 Kings verse 2 verse 15. We thank you for a spirit of counsel and might according to Isaiah 11 verse 2. We thank you for a contrite spirit according to Psalm verse 34 verse 18, that you would loosen a spirit of knowledge according to Isaiah 11 verse 2, that you would loosen, Lord, a good spirit according to Psalm 143 verse 10, that you would loosen a new spirit into our hearts, Lord, according to Ezekiel 11 verse 9, that you would give us a new heart and a new spirit, and you will put your spirit upon us, Lord. We thank you for a free spirit according to Psalm 51 verse 12. We thank you for a quickening spirit according to 1 Corinthians 15 verse 45. We thank you for a spirit of the living creature according to Ezekiel 11 verse 20. We thank you for a spirit of grace and supplication according to Zechariah 12 verse 10. We thank you for a spirit of holiness according to Romans 1 verse 4. We thank you for a spirit of Christ according to Romans 8 verse 9. We thank you for the spirit of grace to be loosened upon our life according to Hebrews 10 verse 29. We thank you, Lord, for a spirit of grace and blessing to be upon us according to Psalm 115 verse 12 to 15. We thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord, for you'll be contraining and contrite heart according to Psalm 34 verse 18. We thank you, Lord Jesus, Lord, that you have given us that ability. We thank you for the spirit of deliverance according to Obadiah chapter 1 verse 17. We thank you, Lord, for the joy of the Lord is our strength. We thank you, Lord, that you have given us life according to Revelation 11 verse 12. We thank you, Lord, for love that you've given to us, 2 Timothy 1 verse 7. You've given us a spirit of love, a spirit of power, love, and of a sound mind. Lord, we thank you in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you for peace. We thank you, Lord, that you would loosen peace, you would loosen honor, you would loosen humility, praise, prayer, grace. Lord, that you would loosen many good things. You would loosen faithfulness. You would loosen, Lord, every aspect of our lives that we need to be blessed today in the name of Jesus Christ. I thank you, Father, for each person that has heard this prayer, that is hearing this tongue. Let them be blessed today as we decree, as we declare these things. Let there be a move of the Holy Spirit to touch them from the top of their heads to the soles of their feet right now, Father. I thank your Holy Spirit right now that you have touched them and filled them in the name of Jesus Christ. Fill them from the top of their head to the soles of their feet right now. We thank you, Father, for your goodness. We thank you for the authority that you've given to your Son, who has given to the church. And he said that on this rock I shall build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. We speak blessings and goodness upon all things. In Jesus' mighty name we pray and believe. In Jesus' name, amen. This is Pastor Robert Clancy from Narrow Path Ministries in Perth, Western Australia. It is time to catch the fire of repentance revival as we prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Shalom, shalom, shalom.